Yeah, boo boo.
Mama.
Yeah, boo boo.
Mommy.
I love you.
I
love you. Yeah, Ira. Brookie aan, silly. Ira, Ira, Brookie aan. Broek, short. Short. Ja. Ja.
Bouw. Bouw.
Bouw. Oh, wow. Quack, quack, quack. Yeah, I know, but it... He's scared. Yeah! Watch where you're going.
Quack, quack. Is he stop?
Good job, big boy. Hey guys, so I started vlogging today and then, I don't know, we was at the park and I think I was just trying to walk around and really see the park. It was our first time that we were there. Didn't even find what I was looking for. The Sedgwick County Park has this special toddler park. I don't know. Like, we didn't find it. We found like another little playground for Idris, but not really the big toddler park that I saw online and wanted to go see. Okay, because that was gonna annoy me for the rest of the video. Benjamin put the baby down for his nap. He should still be down for a little while. And I'm just feeling really exhausted and low on energy. The thing is, I've been feeling really low on energy for like quite some time now. I want to say it really started when I stopped breastfeeding. At that point, I also stopped taking, it's not like medication, but I also stopped drinking Gatorade. Because as I said in a couple of other vlogs or other videos, is that I drank like Gatorade every day. A good couple of liters, and preferably the red one, even though I liked mango and the green apple one. The fruit punch was the best way for me to produce the largest amount of breast milk and also obviously stay hydrated, and the electrolytes help with the breast milk. And the little amount of sugar that is in the Gatorade is good because I have like I have low blood sugar, and I also have like liver issues, and it was just the best to keep me balanced. And ever since like stopping all that, I just feel like a lack of energy. But the last couple of weeks have really been like the worst. I feel if I do not drink any coffee in the morning, I'm not gonna be able to play and be active with Idris like how he needs me to be active and how he wants me to be active. But then at the same time, I can't stand coffee, so coffee makes my stomach go all kinds of crazy, and I end up being in the bathroom. At this point, it doesn't even hurt anymore, but it's gotta come out. And that's not really fun because I cannot drink coffee if I know that we're going out that day. Because guarantee, like the first couple of hours, I'm gonna have to like go to the restroom every so often. So yeah, I'm just saying all that to say that Ramadan is coming. It's I don't know if like the exact date is already known. It's either May 14th or May 15th. And for maybe some of you that do not know, Ramadan is the holy month in Islam. You stay away of food, water, everything. Also, you're not allowed to kiss or be intimate with your partner. You're not allowed to smoke. You shouldn't be gambling and all that, other stuff that's really not that good for you, whether it's physically or mentally. But predominantly, we're focusing on the food here. I mean, what I'm trying to say is being focused on the food. So, with my husband being Muslim, I've done Ramadan since like years ago. I can't even. Well, it started when we moved in, when we really lived together. So I want to say 2014 is when I really did it, like the full month. And then obviously I did not do it when I was pregnant because you're not supposed to do it if you're either too young, if you're too old, if you're ill, or if you're pregnant. And so I didn't do it when I was pregnant, and you're also not supposed to do it when you're breastfeeding. So I didn't do it last year because I was still breastfeeding. So the joke over here was I'm trying to get pregnant or be breastfeeding some baby every year. But this year that's not the case. So I'm fasting again. And I'm just a little worried. I'm worried and like a little stressed out because I really want to go and see a doctor before to get my levels checked again. It's been a good 2 or 3 years since I've done like a whole blood work. I really need to see what the levels are of my liver and other things in my body so I can adjust my diet accordingly. Not that I'm on a diet, but adjust my nutrition accordingly. So I can stay energized because I'm really stressed about having like, a blood drop. What's it called? A sugar drop. That's what I call it. I always say an episode, because I don't usually faint because I can sense it really good. I'm really in tune with my body, so I can sense it before it happens, and I immediately, lay on the floor, put my legs in the air. It's just that I don't want that to happen. I don't want to be like on the ground or on the couch half a day, not being able to entertain Idris like he wants to, like he needs to, because he's a very, very active little guy who loves to be outside, which is great, which is absolutely great. And I know it's been done, for centuries, so I don't want to seem like, oh my God, I'm just, with me not knowing what's currently going on with my body, I'm feeling a little stressed out of not having seen a doctor beforehand and adjusting my meals accordingly. What am I supposed to take in? What do I have to cut out? All that stuff. And then also, I've been trying to gain weight because I lost a lot of weight after having Idris, after breastfeeding. I lost a lot of weight. And usually, when you're fasting, you tend to lose weight. So that's going to be tricky as well because I've never done fitness or any type of workouts really consistently in general, let alone during Ramadan. I used to be a dancer, so that was like my main source of exercise. But I don't think that I'm gonna be like working out during Ramadan. I really can't see that. Also, we have company, we have guests coming. Well, not guests. We have a guest coming, Yusuf. So yeah, I hope he's not too bored. But usually, during Ramadan, there's not too much activities that you really go out to look for. But hopefully, he's not going to be super bored, and we're still going to be doing some activities. My husband will probably also fast. As I said before, he's Muslim, so he's the reason why I fast. But he has had health issues last year, and he was not allowed to fast last year. So he needs to check with that particular doctor this year to see if he's allowed to join in again. So yeah, it's going to be definitely tricky this year, and I'm stressed out, but I think I'm making it like more of a big deal in my head than what it is. I definitely just need to get back to Gatorade though, because it's easier for me to drink than coffee. I don't have any stomach issues and it gives me energy and it has a nice little taste. And it's, to me, it's just like water, meaning when you go to the bathroom and the toilet looks like how it should be, if you understand what I'm saying. So yeah, this has been, wow, okay, I've been talking for 12 minutes and I'm probably going to keep a lot of this in because I really wanted to talk about this. Let me know, guys, if you're fasting with a child, how do you keep your energy up? Mind you, my son is 18 months now. Well, he will be at that time. He will be 18 months on May 13th. So literally the day or 2 days before Ramadan starts. So if you have any tips and tricks for me on what I can do, to stuff that I can eat in the morning that will have my energy good and balanced throughout the day until at night with iftar, because definitely suhoor is, I'm a not wake up at suhoor and then just go the whole day without anything, and then come iftar I just stuff my face. I was able to do that because I was either laying on the couch, you know, the whole day, or I was at work, but I had a desk job, so it was kind of fine, you know what I'm saying? So all this stuff is changing. I definitely need to get up at suhoor and eat. I need to know proteins, carbs, exactly what I'm taking in, because I just need energy, guys. I'm just stressed out that, because you don't know my son, man. Like, he gets out of his bed and he is ready to start his day kicking. Again, if you have any tips or tricks, please help a girl out. I don't even know how much more I'm gonna vlog, because this vlog is gonna be like 20 minutes, half an hour with just me talking. The baby's awake. Oh my god. I have to go back. I forgot to get his drink. He's always super, super thirsty when he wakes up, so I gotta get his drink. He only drinks water when it's in the bottle itself. He doesn't like water in his sippy cup, so. Okay. And something like completely different? What was I gonna say? Something completely different. These are some of the best cups, like sippy cups. Like, we have a bunch, but this comes in a set with the octopus is like underwater stuff and the dinosaurs. The reason why I love it, I have a tendency to over screw the lids to make it super tight, because I always fear like stuff will leak, even with his bottles when he used to drink milk. I always screw them on too tight and then he has to suck really hard. These two actually have a seal zone. I don't know if it's picking up well on camera. A seal zone. It goes from light until really, really sealed. And so because of that and the little arrow that's here, it gives me the perfect idea. Like, yep, this is the hardest way. This is the tightest sealing you have to do. It's not going to leak. And he just sucks normally and it comes out. If you have issues with that, get these Gerber sippy cups, okay? Let's go see my boo-boo! Hi!
Mama!
Yeah, I'm Mama! You're a baby! Hi, Mama! You're the baby, silly!
Mama!
Yeah, that's me, that's me! That's me, that's me!
Mama!
That's me! Mwah! Ah, oh, my! Thank you, very boo-boosh!
Booty cat?
Mama!
Ninja. Is this an egg in the... What is it? 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 Oh my god, guys, it's already like 5 o'clock. You know I'm on the schedule to have the baby have his meal at 5:30. I was like on the phone with my mom and didn't realize the time. Benjamin is out getting stuff that I still need for dinner tonight, and he hasn't returned home yet. So I'm like, come on, we all know what the baby's time is. I hate when that happens. So I saw this recipe for Turkish Ramadan bread, which is what I'm trying to make today to see if it's good for me to make during the Ramadan. Okay, Nen, that's a schoen. The schoen moet daar, Idris. That's vies, that's vuil. Schoen beneden, yeah. Good job. Yeah, see, and he wants to go outside and play, so Benjamin had to be back by this point to play with him outside while I make dinner. The dinner that I'm gonna make has to go into the oven. The bread has to go into the oven. I'm irritated. I'm irritated. Highly irritated. So anyways, yeah, so I found this bread. Turkish Ramadan bread or something is what it's called. I'll link it down below. And I want to try to make it to see if it's like an easy thing for me to make during Ramadan itself. And if we like it, you know, how it all plans out, because obviously bread is like, so we need to, I need to try it first. Oh wow, that's a lot of light still. Okay. This makeup needs to come off. It's about 8:23 and the baby is... Oh, okay, it was the TV. Yep. I was like, okay, camera. Well, we're just gonna have to work with it. Benjamin, right there. Right there. I don't do like insects. I don't even know what I was gonna say. Yeah, so I just put the baby to bed because usually that's something that Benjamin does. He does nighttime routine, as you guys saw in our nighttime routine video. But right now he was really crying for me, so I was just like, I'll do it. So he's in his bed, asleep. And I'm gonna end the vlog here because I know that I already have a lot of footage with me talking about Ramadan and all that stuff. And I did not get to make the dinner that I wanted to make. Like, the bread did not work. First of all, I put the First of all, I put the salt in because I was reading the ingredients and not watching the video, and I wasn't supposed to put the salt in until after I was kneading the yeast and the sugar into the flour. Anyway, so I messed that up. I put in way too much water, so I was like, no, I'm not even gonna try that. Then I saw the hour and I was like, oh my god, it's too late to even start the Turkish dish because it has to go into the oven for 90 minutes, and Anyways, I had some sweet potatoes, the guys had some tomatoes and fish, and it was just a real quick last minute struggle dinner, to be honest. But hey ho, tomorrow is a new day and tomorrow will be a great dinner. So I will probably film tomorrow, although it's looking like Saturday and Sunday is going to be two separate vlogs, because that's just one long vlog. So yeah, that's about it, guys. I can't wait to wipe this all off. I'm gonna do it now. So thank you so much for watching. Oh, and then I'm washing. So thank you guys so much for watching, and then I will see you in the next one. Bye.